everybody, and welcome. Jeff Siegel here, and I'm going to introduce you to a new technology called Levels. It comes in this little box, and it is a continuous blood glucose monitor. And for the next 28 days, I am going to be wearing this little device on my arm, syncing it with my phone, and getting data on what my body is doing to regulate my blood sugar throughout the day. And so you might be asking, hey, I thought blood sugar monitors were just for diabetics. And the answer is yes. And this is such a powerful technology that they're beginning to roll it out to the public to empower people to make better decisions about the food that they eat, about how they take care of their body, right? Why? Because measuring your blood sugar is one of the most important and beneficial things that you can do. And it's really difficult, if not impossible, to do, right, without specific technology. All you can do is notice the symptoms of blood sugar that's too high or blood sugar that's too low, but you never get that granular data of actually being able to see how specific foods at times of day and how exercise and all these other factors are affecting your body's ability to manage and to regulate your blood sugar, right? So there's three important reasons why tracking your blood sugar can be so, so important for your health, right? One is that your blood sugar has a huge impact on your hunger and your mood, right? If you've ever experienced being hangry, that sudden onset of really wanting to eat, of being really irritable, low mood, kind of angry, right? That's usually a sign that your blood sugar is on some sort of roller coaster. And it's so if you would like to have an even keel, right? A steady mood and normal hunger throughout the day that doesn't get too extreme, then regulating your blood sugar is one really important factor that's gonna play into that. The second reason that monitoring your blood sugar can be helpful is that your blood sugar and the release of insulin that high blood sugar can cause, right, ultimately impacts your metabolism and what sort of fuel your body is burning. Right? Having your body with a high blood sugar and high amounts of insulin, right, impairs your body's ability to burn fat as fuel. So knowing how your blood sugar is doing is ultimately telling you whether the food that you're eating is going to be burned or whether it's going to be stored as fat, or whether you're keeping your sugar and your insulin levels low enough during the day to be able to burn fat as fuel, to allow the mitochondria, the little powerhouses inside your cells, to tap into your fat reserves. And so knowing what's going on in your body gives you this powerful insight where you can begin to optimize your metabolism, where you can make sure that your cells are getting the energy that they need, where you're not getting overly dependent or relying on sugars, where you have that flexibility at the cellular level to burn both fat and sugar. And this is not only going to help you if you're trying to lose weight or stay trim, but it's going to help you because it can reduce inflammation, it can prevent cellular damage, right? It can create a more robust metabolic system, and that's ultimately what we're going for here. And then the third reason why this device can be so powerful is that it gives you this individualized snapshot into how specific foods are affecting your body. Because guess what? You can eat an apple and you can eat a pear, and they both might have the same amount of sugar, the same amount of carbohydrates. But because your body is unique, because your microbiome is unique, because your genetics are unique and your lifestyle is unique, how that apple versus that pear affects you could be very different. And so with this technology, you can see how any individual food might impact your blood sugar and how eating that apple at 7 a.m. when you first wake up versus at 11 a.m. after a little bit of time, how does that affect your blood sugar? Right? Or if you eat that apple and sit on the computer and do work, or eat that apple and then go for a walk, how does that affect your blood sugar? So you can begin to tease out all of these different lifestyle factors and pay attention and notice, hey, when I do this, it actually makes my blood sugar normal, but when I do that, I go on this crazy roller coaster ride and I get back to this place of being crazy hungry and crazy angry. And so all of these are things that I am looking forward to exploring. And so for the next 28 days, I'm gonna take you on this journey together with me of monitoring my blood sugar. I'm gonna do a little check-in video. And I'm gonna share this with you, right? not because I'm trying to promote this product, right? I have no affiliation with Levels. At the end, I will give you my full and honest review of whether I think this is an appropriate technology for you. But I'm going to share this data because I hope that by doing so, by giving you a little snapshot into my eating habits and my lifestyle and how it impacts my blood sugar and my metabolism, it will empower you to make better decisions about what you eat and how you move and how you take care of your body. So until next time, this is Jeff Siegel. Breathe, smile, and take that next step on that journey towards whatever is most important for you.